mark this union in marriage between Michael and Kyung. It's kind of funny that I'm here to talk about love because, I mean, to be honest, I really don't know anything. But I have learned a few things watching Michael and Kyung over the years that I want to share with you. One of which is, love is not always patient. Love is not always kind. Love is whatever makes it work between two people. There is no one definition that fits and works for everyone, or that's something that can be contained in a few trite phrases. I'm grateful for the opportunity that I've had to learn from Mike and Kyung over the past years, both as they've done in the past and as they continue to do so in the future. So, from what I can see, Michael and Kyung's love can be boiled down to two things: consistent and real. To elaborate, I'm going to go back to second semester of freshman year when I was moving in with Michael. We'd hung out a few times in the past, but to be honest, I didn't really know him that well. I just had a few surface observations, and pretty much what I gathered was he's tall, he's definitely athletic, he's from Tennessee, and he had told me that he was being recruited to play football by Yale, which I later found out was the truth. So, to be honest, I was pretty intimidated. I was expecting to be living with a loud, brash, rough southern jock. But what I was surprised to find that I was actually living with a gentle, goofy guy who just wanted to play basketball, watch Korean dramas, talk about girls, and work on his freestyle rap. Same thing I had with her. When I first saw her, I saw short, she's pretty, she has a high voice, she has a small, round face. So, right or not, I was expecting a bubbly, ditzy, cutesy, like Hello Kitty type of girl, and all you know that she is none of those things. She is a hard-nailed badass that can burn you with her tongue just as easily as with her level 90 shadow face. I knew I liked Kyung when one night we all went to a hookah bar. We got into a room where they told us that it would cost $300 just to use the room. I mean, we all got quiet, we were all looking at each other until finally Kyung goes, "I just want to go to McDonald's." And that night I told Mike, "We need to marry this girl." So pretty much what I've gathered was, they said I was a little up to Tuesday. Okay, so the two of them are so unabashedly themselves, and in ways that contradict any initial ideas and perceptions that you form about them. So much so that for a long time, I thought that they were putting up a front, and I was trying in vain to see who the real Michael and Kyung were. It took me too long to realize the truth, which is Michael really is a goofy, gentle guy who just wants to have fun with his friends, and Kyung really is a cool as hell girl who doesn't need the fluffy stuff. I have plenty of stories to tell, but Michael said I could take a few shots first before I get into that, so going back to love. In a lot of ways, Michael and Kyung's love has enabled them to grow and mature to who they are today, provided structure and definition at a time when a lot of people are floating and wandering aimlessly. It allowed them to say, "This is who I am. This part of my life is concrete. No matter what happens, I'll be okay because we have each other." It's not the kind of love that you'll find in movies with fluffy clouds and birds singing all over the place. It's the kind of love that sustains as opposed to a kind of love that lays foundations before building walls and checks that the rope is secure before jumping. We come now to the words where Michael and Kyung will lay the last touches to the foundation that for the next chapter of their lives. The words that will take them across the threshold from being engaged to being married. A marriage, as most of us understand it, is a voluntary full commitment made sense to the exclusion of all others. It is entered into with the desire and hope that will last a lifetime. So before you declare your vows, please confirm that it is indeed your intention to be married today. Kyung and Park, do you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to Michael in marriage?
I do.
Michael Chang, do you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to marriage today? Kyung and Michael, having heard that it is your intention to be married to each other, we can exchange the vows. As many of you already know, Kyung and Michael are probably the least PDA couple ever, So instead of reciting their personal vows in public, they have chosen to write letters, expressing their personal commitment to one another. The letters are sealed in bottles, and they have not seen what the other has written. The bottles will be kept at home as a constant reminder of the commitment they have made to each other. So if you could. Now for the exchange of the rings. The rings that you're about to exchange are a symbol of the promises you have made to each other. It represents two hands, always connected with steadfast devotion, and the promise that things will always be okay because you have each other.
Kyung this ring.
I give as a token and pledge. As a sign of my love and devotion. With this ring. Your spoken promises signify the beginning of our lives together. Come in, Michael. May you live happily ever after, and your days blessed with love and laughter. By the power invested in me, by the state of Georgia, and the whole county, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Thank you.